Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Happy Valentine's Day. This is our Valentine's Day weekend Journeys of Hope conversation. And this weekend, we have a guest na dapat matagal ko na ito naging guest. Ang tagal na namin pinaplano itong aming conversation. And actually, just a quick background. Actually, this coming March, we would have known each other for 20 years. I first met her during the wake of Rikoyan. That was the time that we first met. Of course, diba, sabi nga nila, diba, that pain and suffering, you look for company, no? You want to know you are not alone. So during that time, it was a tremendous time of pain, yes, for many in ABS, but also it was a time of really making new friendships and building a new community. So for this weekend, we're very happy and we're very grateful that our good friend Nikki Valdez is joining us to share her own journey. Hi, Nick. Good morning. Good day.
Good day, Father. So finally here to share with you yung journey ko. And tama yon. It's 20 years na pala.
20 years, yeah.
20 years pala yon. Yes. It was through a very good friend that we met, and I'm so happy that we have continued to be friends over the years, Father, and you're always there for me whenever I need you. I attend your masses, kami ng family ko, because it's just like, you know, talking to you. Pero syempre, may kasamang misa, may kasamang blessing. I'm very, very blessed.
Yeah, and I think, Nick, alam mo, very few people know your own journey, di ba? Very few people, di ba? Very close friends. Not that because you're hiding it, but I guess hindi magsususpecha yung mga tao. Ha? Yan pala yung dinadaanan niya or yan yung dinaanan niya, no?
But I guess, opo, siguro kasi ganun din akong klase ng tao. Hindi naman ako, hindi siguro ganun ka-colorful yung life ko. I don't know na hindi nila napapag-usapan. But yeah, I think what they know lang is, syempre, I'm a mom. I've been in the business for almost 25 years now. Wow. And sa March po yun. This coming March, I'll be turning 25 years in the business. And yun, siguro yung iba dahil siguro yung nakikita nila sa akin, di ba? I'm always a happy person, Father.
Yes, yes. Oo, di ba? Like, comedian eh, di ba? May pagka-comedian, di ba? So, Nix, yung palang Got to Believe is one of your early projects, no? That was 25 years ago, no? Or 20, yeah. 20, oh, that 25 years ago, di ba?
That was
2003.
So, opo, okay. Mga 19 years.
Ah, so 25 years ago. Sorry, I was thinking 20.
Yeah. Yun.
Okay. Okay.
So, that's what they know, di ba? Yung happy-go-lucky person. Maboka ako, yung diba, yung kwento lang ng kwento. Lagi akong siguro sa kwentuhan, I will always have something to share. So hindi nila alam that, well, we all go through so many struggles in life also. Yeah. And hindi ako kasama ako doon.
Yeah, baka maybe you can tell them your journey, di ba? Where you are now. Kasi kanina nga, di ba, pinag-uusapan natin na discovering God's purpose, ano, even through challenging times. So maybe you can share your journey with them, ano? So.
Opo. Well, short, brief background to everyone who does not know. Marami namang nakakaalam that I got married recently about 3 years ago, and hindi yan yung first marriage ko. We have a child, and si Olivia, who is 13 years old now. And after the separation, I met this wonderful man, si Luis, and yun na nga, we got married 3 years ago, and parang siya na yung tumayong ama ni Olivia. But of course, we talk about and we were saying na it would be nice sana to have our own para magkaroon din naman ng sibling si Olivia. And we did after how many years? Last year lang kasi it was last year when I was able to relax a bit and plan to have a baby. Kaya ginawa na namin para habang pahinga pa, habang wala pang masyadong work. And nakakapili pa po kasi ako ng work noon after 7 months of working from October 2020. The last teleserye I did was Bagong Umaga. So after that, medyo naka-stop ng konti kasi alam mo, father ang lock-in tapings ngayon, diba? Para kami OW, we're away from our families and we spend 21 days maximum of a month during lock-in tapings. So nung natapos na yon, I was able to relax a bit and yun, push forward with what we have been planning for so long. Luis and I underwent in vitro fertilization treatment. Sa mga hindi nakakaalam, yun eh yung ipa-fertilize yung sperm at saka yung egg outside, tapos saka ilalagay sa babae to be able to conceive. So we did that. I did a workup. This was kasi advised already by 2 of our doctors. So sabi namin, let's give it a try. I was looking forward so much kasi sabi ko, I prayed for it before doing it, and I felt that we were both led to it. It's not an easy process, pero sabi ko nga, pinagdasal naman namin. So I was thinking, eto na yon, this is it. We were gonna do it. And so we did. On the first try, hindi kami nakabuo.
Okay.
So, man, wait. Itutuloy ba natin? Kasi pinagdasal nga namin, and we felt, we strongly felt that we were gonna do it. Na may blessing. We finally did. And nung pangalawa, nakabuo. I couldn't explain the feeling na nung tumawag sa amin yung clinic. And finally, ipapasok na siya, no? Itatransfer na siya sa akin. Pero, yun, hindi siya nag-push through. And, did I feel sad? Yes. I went through a stage of depression. Pero, again, because nga hindi nakikita ng tao, I guess because of my happy demeanor. Yun, ngayon ko lang nare-reveal. Actually, I posted it after, during our anniversary, when we celebrated our third anniversary. So, yun, up to now, di ko naman pumasabi na I'm totally fine. There are days that pag mag-isa ako, bigla na lang iiyak, or I always ask why. I don't think, and I feel that sometimes I don't deserve it, but you know, sabi ko nga kay God, maybe you have a purpose. And there is a purpose in everything. That maybe hindi ko lang pa naiintindihan ngayon. And it's just nice that I'm able to talk about it openly. Because I know that I'm not the only one going through this. Just recently, I had a talk with a friend and nalaman ko na, ganun din pala siya. Kasi she the process also. So sabi ko, ay okay, So normal pala yung naramdaman ko. And despite me being I read devotions every day to get mm-hmm. through. And kaya siguro lang po mukha akong okay. But it's a process. And yeah. It's all right, diba, Father, to go through that process.
Yeah.
As long as you don't lose your faith. Feeling ko yun yung nagdala sa akin. Hindi ako nawawala ng tiwala at saka yeah. panangin sa Diyos na hindi naman niya kami pababayaan. Kasi there's so many things in my life na
yeah.
I'd like to look back on. And dun ko na lang ifo-focus yung kung walang Diyos, kung wala yung panalangin ko na yun sa Kanya, yung relationship ko na yun sa Kanya, tingin ko wala na din ako.
Yeah. Next, alam mo, I think there are two important points na maybe if we could share a little bit more, kasi I think that will help a lot of people, ano? Kasi mm-hmm. if you, in your journey with this family, ano, no, family dream, number one, the discernment to say, okay, let's do this, diba? To make that, kasi dumaan din kayo ni Luis sa proseso, diba? I remember when I saw you, I remember of all places, diba, sa isang wake. Do you remember? And you were already asking for prayers for that, diba?
Mm-hmm.
And then, that's the first, baka pwede mo i-sharing discernment process. And then the second one is, when the second attempt failed and then you went into depression, what was it that helped you, no? What was it that helped you process that depression, no? So maybe if you could share more about these two points, maybe first the discernment to push through, no, with the IVF.
So, yun nga, yung discernment ko po kasi, Father, nung time na yun is to, like, nandyan lahat. We were provided for. We know it's not a cheap process. Mm-hmm. So, first, sabi namin, let's do it because the funds are there. Mm-hmm. Pangalawa is, si Olivia noon would always come to me and say na, you're gonna get pregnant soon. Ganon. So parang feeling ko tuloy, I was, the Lord was speaking through her. or yun na nga, ngayon, iniisip ko, baka naman it's just really yung kagustuhan niya talaga magkaroon ng kapatid. So, sabi ko, all the signs were there. And yun talaga yung sinasabi sa akin nung pinagdasal namin. So, iba yung feeling ko noon. Wala akong feeling of hesitation because, ano, Father, it's before I had that discernment. Matagal nang sinasabi sa amin. It's just that hindi ko talaga magawa noon because wala akong maramdaman na I should do it.
Yeah, yeah. Walang urge, you know, walang ano.
Wala
inspiration. Talaga. Maybe the word inspiration is better than urge.
Yeah, wala po talaga. So come itong mid 2021. That's when I felt that let's go for it.
Yeah.
It wasn't easy also because syempre Luis and I had to be on the same page. Diba?
Yeah.
We that's why we really prayed hard for it. And sa kanya nga, sabi niya, ako, okay naman na ako. Siya nga yung happy na ako. I consider Olivia mine.
Yes, yes.
Ako yung, siguro kaya ko pinush is because as a woman na nabigyan ng pangalawang pagkakataon magkaroon ng maayos na marriage. Ako naman yung in return, I wanted to give him this gift.
Yes.
You know, and I told my doctor this, no, yung during the process that kung si Luis lang okay, pero sabi ko bakit ako yung gustong-gusto talaga na ibalik sa kanya yung kabutihan niya para sa lahat ng nagawa niya sa amin ni Olivia. That's why siguro po, yun din, ganun din ako ka kapilit yeah. na ito. It's not for me, it's really for him. Yes. So, kaya super excited talaga ako.
Mm-hmm.
Pangalo, nung second, yung sinasabi niyo po na i-share ko, the feeling that I felt then mm-hmm. when it didn't happen. Kaya feeling ko tuloy, father, parang alam mo yun, yung naputol yung excitement, naputol uh-huh. yung all of a sudden, so hindi pala tama yung discernment ko or ang daming questions.
Oo, uh-huh. yeah.
Ang dami pong, but nagalit ba ako kay Lord? Hindi ako nagalit, pero
may questioning, di ba? May questioning.
Kasi talaga ngayon, up to now, is why?
Mm-mm.
Why can't we have the desires of our hearts when the intentions are pure?
Yes. How did you process that, di ba? Kasi malalim na ano yun, malalim na conversation with God, eh, di ba? I always tell people, ano yan, eh, that's the agony in the garden conversation, di ba? That's the agony in the garden prayer, di ba? So how did you process that?
Well, like I mentioned earlier, I have this daily devotional.
Mm-hmm.
And I have friends to share it with, family. Ma-importante po kasi yun eh, na meron kang strong support system talaga. Mm-hmm. And nakakatawa, Father, kasi when I scroll through my social media accounts,
uh-oh.
Ang dami kong nakikitang tungkol sa pagbubuntis, tungkol sa in vitro fertilization. So sabi ko, hindi uh-oh. Lang siguro ako talaga yung nagtatanong why.
Uh-oh.
And it really helped me a lot during the process. I'm not totally fine because up to now, happy naman po ako pag nakakakita ako ng pregnancy announcements. I never naman ako naka-feel ng parang bakit siya.
Yeah. Tapos, walang inggit.
Wala naman. It's just that yung question ko is for myself
mm-hmm.
na bakit hindi nag-proceed despite all the signs, all the discernments
yeah.
From you, bakit hindi nag-proceed?
Yeah.
And up to now, that's really what I am praying for, na maintindihan ko po
yeah.
yung kung ano man yung nangyayari.
We'll go back to that, no? Because I think that's an important point. Yung prayer mo now is to understand, no? It's not, I guess it's not so much to question God, no? But to understand lang, help me understand. We'll go back to that. But I just want to ask, how was Luis through all this? No? Ano yung kanyang process naman? No?
Well, he cries with me. That's the only thing naman that he could offer. And, you know, Luis is the most understanding and patient person. Kaya din siguro mm-hmm. ako ganito. Andun siya sa it is what it is. You know, we did yeah. our best. Ginawa natin lahat. So wala pong bahid ng ano, kahit na anong sama ng loob galing sa kanya. Maybe meron, pero yung to doubt, to question. Ako yung ganun.
Uh-oh.
Ako yung ganun na bakit? Bakit? Okay naman. Okay yung test. Okay lang.
Uh-oh.
Siya yung ganun talaga eh. So I think he's part of yung process that I had to go through.
Mm-hmm.
That I had to face. Pero siya yung pinaka, dahil nga understanding siya, ang dali nung pinagdaanan ko. Parang napaka maintindihin kasi. So, ang gaan ng lahat. Na even if I feel bad at times at I just blurt out na, naiiyak na naman ako, ganyan, sasabihin lang niya, o di iiyak mo lang. Siya yung kind of person who just knows how to listen when you need.
So and ano no, amazing support group, no? I mean with Luis around. And how was Olivia? How was Olivia na?
Paano ko ba i-explain? Sabi niya kasi noon, di ko alam kung may sa pangmangula itong anak ko, father, or ano, or yun na nga, baka, you know, if the spirit is speaking through her, I don't know. Kasi sabi niya, Mama, you're gonna have a baby. Pero, may pagdadaanan kayo ni Dada. Yun ang sabi niya. Medyo may struggle. Sabi niyang ganon. So, when this happened, actually umiyak siya nung nalaman niyang nakabuo. And then after, nung pag-uwi namin and we told her nga na, wala, hindi siya kumapit. Parang siguro tanggap niya, maybe because nga she knows, for some reason, because nga nanggaling sa kanya yung message na yun eh.
Yeah.
Na, it's gonna happen, but you're gonna have to go through so many things. So, I think by having her said that, tanggap niya na meron talagang kailangan pagdaanan. Sabi ko, oh, sana meron ako nung strength niya, nung heart niya, diba? Yung ano po eh, sa age niya na 13, so she understands so many things, but ang galing niya pong maintindihan yung nangyayari at saka yun, yung pain ko. Parang ngayon, okay naman. I don't hear her say na nangungit siya. Dati nga kasi hawak ng hawak sa tiyan ko yan. Baby. Ngayon, I think she's matured enough to understand pain.
Yeah.
But at the same time, of course,
encouraging siya, no? Very encouraging yung kanyang...
Opo.
Yeah. So, now going back now to what you're saying, at this point, you're at that stage na you've accepted, no? Tanggap mo, but you're also asking for, I guess, a deeper understanding, no? I don't know if I'm saying that right, no?
Yes.
Or a deeper purpose, I don't know if tama ba yon. So, how was that? Where are you now in this journey?
As I've said, siguro po minsan I just choose to shy away from it because I don't want to dwell. I'm not the type of person to dwell so much on the pain.
Mm-mm.
And I just keep telling myself, Father, na there is a reason, there is a reason. And I do everything para hindi ko lang siya talaga, para hindi ako masyadong masaktan.
Mm-hmm.
Because I am a believer of na kailangan mo lang to be in the moment. Na gawin yung mga bagay na kaya mong i-control. Huwag mo nang unahan. So I just keep on telling myself that there is a purpose, but that's what I'm praying for. Na maintindihan ko ano ba yung purpose na yun na gusto mong ipagawa sa akin. Mm-hmm. And in so many situations in my life, the good comes, the answer comes when I just totally surrender.
Mm-hmm.
When I don't force it, when I don't think about it too much. Nandun ako sa, like, nung na-meet ko si Luis, bago nun, I would enter so many bad relationships.
Mm-hmm.
Because I felt I kept forcing it, you know, trying to find love pero from the wrong people pala.
Mm-hmm.
When I finally said, Lord, ayoko na. Ikaw na lang ang bahala. He came just like that. Not in the best of circumstances, pero he just came. Uh-huh. Like, ganon. So, doon na po ako ngayon. I'm just praying, understand. Pero nandun na talaga ako. Na total surrender talaga. Yeah. To will, to what God wants from me, for me. Kasi sa lahat naman ng prayers ko, even when I was asking for discernment before the treatment, at the end of the prayer, it's always your will for me, what you want for me, and not what I want. Kasi minsan, yung gusto natin, hindi naman yun yung para sa atin. Baka mamaya, makasama siya. But again, I'm still praying kung bakit ito yung nangyari sa akin.
And I guess, ano, sabi mo nga, di ba, na even if there is that surrender, your will, it's a surrender in freedom, eh, di ba, na may question ka, gusto mong unawain, and yet at the same time you're saying, no, sige, your will, but this is what I'm going through, ito yung nasa isip ko, ito yung nasa damdamin ko. Kumbaga, hindi mo deny, maybe that's the word that I'm looking for. Walang denial nung dinadaanan mo, even as you say, Lord, your will be done. Kasi sometimes, there is the tendency of denial, eh, di ba? Na agad tatalon tayo, dun, Lord, your will be done. Pero hindi na po proseso yung, ano, next, yung...
Yeah, parang kinasasama pa rin ng loob mo.
Yes.
Ako lang, Father, accepted ko.
Oo.
Andun na nga rin ako minsan sa... I totally accept what happened to me. But again, syempre tao lang po ako. I need understanding beyond that.
Yeah. Clarity, di ba? Oh.
Intervention na.
Yeah.
So ko lang talaga ma-clear yung para maging at peace talaga ako na.
Yes.
Ito pala 'yon. Syempre ganon siguro yung man nature yun, Father, di ba? Na yung gusto mo may kasagutan talaga.
Yes,
para
yeah.
100% okay ka. Yeah. Di ba? But again, nag-doubt ba ako? Hindi nga.
Mm-mm.
It's just that I want that 100% peace from God and blessing na. And ito yun kasi.
Yeah. So next, any final... words to our viewers na
to everyone who has been the same situation like me, all I can say is you will have your time. If whatever it is that you are praying for, that you are working hard for, sometimes if it is unknown, maybe it's not because hindi na ibibigay sa'yo. I always believe that God has better plans, if not better, the best ones. Always, yeah. It never fails. And to just continue on with life.
Mm-hmm.
Ko maraming nagsa-struggle to conceive. Ang daming nagsa-struggle to even live, you know, for the next day. Yeah. And again, hindi naman tayo pababayaan ng Diyos. Kapit lang tayo because for sure, hanggat nabuhay tayo, hanggat humihinga, there is always something better that's come.
Yeah. Well, Nick, thank you very much. And sana magkita-kita na tayo ulit ng face-to-face. Ano?
I pray for that day, Father.
Yes, and we'll continue praying for you, no, especially your journey with God. No? And give my regards to Olivia and to Luis. So,
will do, Father.
Maraming salamat, Nix. Thank you
very much for this, that I'm able to share my journey.
Yeah, thank you for sharing. Thank you for being so open. Salamat.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Sumuri, makialam. Tumindi.
crucial ang 2022. It's the year that we need to come out of this pandemic, diba?
Buhay pa ang sibika sa atin.
Especially for the youth, I think we need something to capture their imagination.
Hindi lahi ang Pilipino, hindi kayo manggi ang Pilipino. So yung pagiging Pilipino, ang ibig sabihin nito, ito yung commitment natin dito sa proyekto ng Pilipinas. At yung proyekto ng Pilipinas ay isang demokratikong proyekto.
Ako si Leloy Claudio.
Ako si Carlos Santiago.
Ako si Manolo Quezon para sa Proyekto Pilipino.